Aaron Haranath struck a career-best 154, but the headlines on the third day of the LV County Championship match between Derbyshire and Surrey were naturally made by Ricky Ponting, who hit an undefeated 100 in his first innings for the visitors. Surrey started the penultimate day of this run fest on 35 for 1 in response to Derbyshire's mammoth 452, but those at the ground hoping to see the former Australian captain in early were left disappointed as Haranath and Vikram Solanki batted with minimal fuss in the morning session. The home side started the day with hopes of causing the Surrey batsmen problems and perhaps even had thoughts of enforcing a follow-on. Such a thing never materialised, of course. Just into the second hour of the morning, Haranath reached his third championship half-century in 8 innings this summer, surviving a brute of a ball from Mark Footit, which he gloved just wide of the wicketkeeper, to earn himself his 7th boundary for the 99th ball he'd faced. He soon offered the only half chance of the morning, drilling a ball from David Wainwright close to the bowler, but not close enough as it turned out. Haranath's partnership with Solanki was worth 133 runs for the second wicket, but was ended just before lunch as the latter, on 35, turned a delivery from Wes Durston via the leg of Richard Johnson to Billy Godelman at leg slip. So Ponting was in after the break, and this was his first scoring shot for his new county, a 2 off Durston, who will perhaps not be the toughest bowler he'll face in his time back in county cricket. Indeed, it was a nice, comfortable start for the Australian legend. An odd thing occurred after lunch, with a number of the Derbyshire players and umpire Nigel Cowley complaining of light-headedness, the umpire being replaced for a while by Surrey's coach Ian Salisbury. Whatever the problem was, it wasn't affecting Ponting, who was soon unleashing the kind of shots every England supporter has become accustomed to over the years. Thanks to Haranath, though, the day wasn't all about Ponting. The left-hander moved easily into the 90s with a slightly risky drive off Tim Groenewald. And his 100, the third of his first-class career, arrived just over an hour after lunch in a wonderful style as he launched Durston straight back over his head for a 6 to take him to 3 figures off 224 balls, that maximum being added to his 13 other boundaries. What a moment it was for the 26-year-old, who was given a deserved pat on the back by Ponting. Not every day you get the chance for such a thing to happen. All of Derbyshire thought that Ponting was out before he'd made it to his 50. Indeed, the bowler Wainwright could hardly believe that when the ball hit Ponting's back leg, that the umpire's finger wasn't raised. Perhaps, just perhaps, there was a little bat involved. The batsman then did what pretty much everyone was expecting him to do. He completed his half century, the 186th time he's got that far in the first class game. A neat flick through the leg side brought him his 6th four to take him to his 50 from his 85th delivery. Already he had people purring as he proved he's lost none of his love for scoring runs, even at the age of 38. He'd started to make the art of scoring runs look rather easy on this good batting surface. All the usual flourishes were there as his partnership for the third wicket with Haranath continued on and on. Haranath's previous best of 109 had now been beaten, and the stand between this pair moved above the 150 mark. Ponting was, of course, so well set by now that 100 on debut was becoming something of an inevitability. These two boundaries, after a watchful spell, came off successive deliveries as he moved into the 70s. The second new ball had made no real difference, and Haranath was now in dreamland, making it to 150 for the first time off his 291st delivery. He rightly received a standing ovation for a memorable innings. This was turning out to be a day he will not forget in a hurry, and one which just may start to turn Surrey's season around. How he would have loved to bat out the day, but on 154 he was bowled by Wainwright in an unusual fashion, the ball coming off the bottom edge of his bat and his foot before rebounding onto his stumps. Haranath had shared in a partnership of 180 and 49 overs with Ponting, who then completed the 81st century of his remarkable career. It's fair to say that he probably secured his other 80 in a rather more stylish fashion, but even as he fell over, he'd found the boundary for the 13th time from his 149th delivery. Few would have bet against him achieving such a feat, even given the excitement of his debut innings, which had been a few days in the making. The batting-friendly day ended quietly, although Wainwright did get one through Xander De Bruyn's defences. He departed just after the 350 had been earned, just inside the bonus point scoring overs. So what to expect for the final day of this match? A draw is inevitable, it seems, as may be plenty more runs from Ponting. He'll go again on 120 after 4 hours at the crease, an innings which has helped his side to 362 for four, which leaves Surrey only 90 runs behind, but probably too many for them to try to make a game of it.